Well, the World Economic Forum has finally admitted what we've been saying here on the show. The US dollar is about to change forever.
De-dollarization is coming. Politicians in the US are already freaking out about the prospect that they won't be able to punish other countries.
The World Economic Forum has convened once again, making a show of convening global leaders to discuss critical issues impacting the world. While their statements and predictions typically draw controversy in the economic and financial world, recently the WEF has suggested a shift in the global dominance of the US dollar. This bold statement has caused shockwaves across the international financial markets and triggered intense discussions among economists, analysts, and policymakers. WEF's admission suggests that profound changes are on the horizon, with various factors driving this change that have implications for the US dollar's future. The World Economic Forum recently acknowledged a significant development that could shape the future of global finance, the impending transformation of the US dollar. Though not entirely surprising, this revelation is a crucial development that deserves closer examination. For years, there has been speculation about the rise of central bank digital currencies known as CBDCs and their impact on traditional currencies like the US dollar. However, the confirmation from the WEF adds weight to these speculations, indicating that 98% of central banks are preparing to launch CBDCs. This shift signifies a monumental change in the global monetary sector. The move towards digital currencies represents a strategic effort to reconfigure control over the monetary system. Traditionally, currencies have been under the authority of individual sovereign governments. However, with CBDCs, there is a specialized effort to transfer this control to larger financial entities, such as Wall Street and multinational banks. This consolidation of power raises concerns about transparency, accountability, and the concentration of financial authority in the hands of a few. One of the primary motivations behind the push for digital currencies is the desire to simplify cross-border transactions and address inefficiencies in the current banking infrastructure. Many proponents argue that CBDCs could facilitate faster and more secure transactions, particularly in interbank payments and securities transactions. However, critics caution against overlooking the drawbacks of this digital transition. Implementing digital currencies raises questions about privacy, surveillance, and individual autonomy. A fully digital currency system would enable unprecedented levels of monitoring and control, allowing authorities to track and trace every transaction in real time. This level of surveillance could infringe upon personal freedoms and worsen data privacy and security issues. Moreover, the transition to CBDCs has its challenges. Legal and regulatory hurdles must be addressed before widespread adoption can occur. The diverse regulatory sectors across different jurisdictions further complicate the process, highlighting the need for international cooperation and standardization. The implications of this transition extend beyond financial markets, affecting various aspects of society, including governance, technology, and individual rights. The WEF's acknowledgement has sparked discussions, debates, and speculations across economic circles as experts struggle with the implications of such a significant change. The US dollar has been the dominant global reserve currency for many years. It has played a crucial role in international trade, finance, and investment. Due to its status as the world's primary currency, the United States has enjoyed significant economic influence and advantages. However, the admission of the WEF indicates that this dominance may be about to change. To fully understand the importance of WEF's acknowledgement, it's necessary to analyze the reasons behind this change. One key factor is the increasing national debt of the United States, which has now reached an enormous $34 trillion. This extraordinary amount of money raises significant concerns about the long-term viability of U.S. fiscal policy and its impact on global financial stability. A significant portion of this debt is owed to foreign entities, most notably China, which holds a substantial share of U.S. Treasury bonds. The reliance on foreign creditors, particularly geopolitical rivals like China, poses inherent risks to U.S. economic sovereignty. As China continues to diversify its reserves and reduce its exposure to U.S. debt, the vulnerability of the U.S. dollar becomes increasingly apparent. Moreover, the national debt structure, comprising intergovernmental and public components, emphasizes the complex web of financial obligations facing the United States. Intergovernmental debt, mainly held by entities like the Federal Reserve and Social Security, intertwines with public debt held by banks, foreign governments, and institutions. This intricate dynamic shows global finance's interconnectedness and the system's inherent vulnerabilities. The WEF's acknowledgement of the impending change in the US dollar signifies a paradigm shift in the international monetary order. As emerging technologies and geopolitical realignments reshape the global economy, traditional notions of reserve currencies and financial hegemony are being challenged. One avenue through which this transformation may manifest is the rise of central bank digital currencies. As stated before, countries worldwide are exploring the development of CBDCs to enhance financial inclusion, streamline transactions, and assert greater control over monetary policy. The increase of CBDCs could undermine the dominance of traditional fiat currencies like the US dollar, leading to a more decentralized and multipolar financial system. Furthermore, the advent of blockchain technology and cryptocurrencies introduces new possibilities for reshaping the global financial architecture. Cryptocurrencies, with their decentralized nature and borderless transactions, offer alternatives to traditional fiat currencies and challenge the dominance of central banks. As countries like El Salvador embrace Bitcoin as legal tender and explore innovative uses of blockchain technology, the traditional boundaries of finance are being redefined. In light of these developments, the future of the US dollar hangs in the balance. While its status as the world's primary reserve currency may persist in the near term, the movement of global economic trends suggests a shift towards a more diversified and inclusive monetary system. As nations adapt to the changing situation of finance, the legacy of the US dollar's dominance may be remembered as a relic of the past, paving the way for a new era of monetary innovation and multipolarity. To fully appreciate the significance of the WEF's admission, it is crucial to understand the historic dominance of the US dollar in the global financial system. The dollar's ascendancy as the world's reserve currency can be traced back to the end of World War II and the Bretton Woods Agreement of 1944. During the Bretton Woods Conference, representatives from 44 allied nations gathered to establish a new international monetary system. The agreement pegged the value of major currencies to the US dollar, which in turn was tied to the gold standard. This arrangement effectively made the dollar the anchor of the global financial system, solidifying its status as the world's reserve currency. The dollar's dominance was further reinforced by the strength of the US economy. The United States emerged from World War II as an economic powerhouse with a robust industrial base, abundant natural resources, and a highly skilled workforce. This economic might lent credibility to the dollar and fostered confidence in its stability and reliability. The depth and liquidity of U.S. financial markets. The size and liquidity of U.S. financial markets, particularly the Treasury securities market, made the dollar an attractive investment and reserve asset for central banks and institutional investors worldwide. The petrodollar system. In the 1970s, the U.S. struck a deal with Saudi Arabia to trade oil exclusively in U.S. dollars. This move, known as the petrodollar system, ensured a constant global demand for the dollar, as nations needed to hold dollar reserves to purchase oil on the international market. Safe haven status. The perceived stability and reliability of the US government and its institutions, coupled with the country's strong rule of law and democratic traditions, made the dollar a safe haven for investors during times of economic or political uncertainty. The mounting US debt burden and fiscal concerns. Apart from CBDCs, the United States' growing debt burden and persistent budget deficits have raised concerns about the long-term sustainability of the dollar's value. As the U.S. government accumulated debt, reaching historically high levels, it may become increasingly difficult to maintain confidence in the dollar's stability and purchasing power. High levels of debt can lead to inflationary pressures, diminishing the dollar's value and undermining its attractiveness as a reserve currency. Additionally, concerns over the U.S. government's ability to manage its fiscal affairs and service its debt obligations further diminish the dollar's credibility on the global stage. Technology and innovation in finance. The rapid pace of technological innovation, particularly in digital finance and blockchain technology, has disrupted traditional financial systems and challenged the dollar's dominance. Innovations such as decentralized finance, known as DeFi platforms, stablecoins, and other emerging financial technologies could diminish the dollar's importance. One scenario is the emergence of a multi-currency world, where several major currencies such as the US dollar, the euro, and the Chinese yuan, and a new digital currency or basket of currencies coexist and compete for global dominance. This scenario could lead to increased currency volatility, complexity in international trade and investment, and a shift in global economic power dynamics. In such a world, nations, businesses, and individuals must adapt to a more diverse and dynamic financial sector where currency hedging and risk management strategies become even more critical. Additionally, the role of international organizations like the International Monetary Fund, IMF, and the World Bank could evolve to facilitate cooperation and coordination in a multi-currency environment. Another possibility is the gradual decline of the US dollar as the dominant reserve currency, paving the way for the rise of a new global reserve currency. This could be a digital currency backed by a consortium of nations, a basket of currencies from major economies, or a new asset-backed currency. Such a scenario would fundamentally reshape the global financial system and redistribute economic power and influence. Countries and institutions holding significant dollar reserves must adjust their portfolios and investment strategies. In contrast, those with the new reserve currency could gain greater global influence. The World Economic Forum's recognition of the upcoming transformation of the US dollar highlights the significant changes happening in the global finance industry. Although central bank digital currencies offer innovation and efficiency, they also raise important concerns regarding control and privacy. As stakeholders navigate this change, it is vital to prioritize transparency, accountability, and protecting individual rights in the evolving financial sector. With increasing debt, political tensions, and technological advancements reshaping the monetary system, the future of the US dollar is uncertain. These challenges and opportunities present a new era in the history of global finance, characterized by innovation, adaptation, and change.